In the heart of Yorkshire, our health service is hard at work.
Emergency department, Barnsley Hospital.
Okay. Just relax, mate.
A dedicated team.
Stop making me laugh.
Working 24 hours a day, 7 days a week.
Look forward for me.
Trainee coming through.
Ready for anything.
I think I've just about got it cracked, this job.
Oh. And everything.
Everybody clear?
Any pain at all?
No.
Still alive, still alive.
Well, you're stuck with me now.
Wow. And our boss.
Lucky you're well.
Facing life.
We're back from the moon.
And death.
Go on, keep going, sweetheart.
Trauma.
Fabulous.
And tears.
I know.
Supporting each other through the toughest shifts.
God help me today.
I'm not coming on, Ken. It's lovely and warm, isn't it?
Is this cut then? Is it like this big or is it like this big?
It's big.
Buckingham Palace one day, Barnsley Hospital next.
Oh, lovely.
It's like champagne.
This is Barnsley Casualty 24/7.
God bless the NHS.
On shift tonight, Matron Hannah Ryan.
Have you got staffing for today? Because we're short tonight, aren't we?
Zane and Cherish rang in sick.
Okay.
Emergency nurse practitioner Kirsty Muscroft.
Something I've definitely never seen in my career here anywhere. It's a story to tell, isn't it?
Yeah, I'm shocked. Very shocked by that.
And advanced clinical practitioner Richard Jackson.
Okay, Kerry, nice and steady.
So get ready to share a shift.
That's
with the team at Barnsley Casualty.
You with us?
The department has a new matron in charge.
Morning. You all right?
Good.
Congrats. Thank you.
It's former lead nurse Hannah's first day in her new role.
It feels a little bit strange to be stood here in a uniform when for 15 years I've wore scrubs. I'm sure I'll get used to it. Eventually. I came down here originally as a BAM 5, as a staff nurse, and I've worked my way through every role. We've got a good team down here. I've always been part of that team, and it just felt right to want to lead that team.
And it seems like the pressure is mounting already.
What's it like?
Initially, they told me there were only two medical beds, but I think I've used up what beds there is now until discharges start happening.
Very busy at the moment. Lots of patients waiting for beds and lots of patients still coming in. But yeah, busy, busy, as always.
The red phone hasn't stopped ringing.
Fans in nurse department.
And patients are flooding in. One man has been urgently rushed to resus from the cardiology clinic with a rapid heart rate.
Hi there, Kerry.
Advanced clinical practitioner Richard is in charge of Kerry's treatment.
So, you got a rapid feeling of the heart.
That's right.
How bad's the pain at the moment?
About 10,
so it's up there. OK, and in March time, you had a very similar episode where you had palpitations, pain like this. Can we have a listen to your heart, bud? Yeah, it's running quite quick, isn't it?
Clinical practitioner Richard quickly needs to get Kerry's heart beating in a regular rhythm.
Kerry's electrical signals are not firing as they should do, so what we need to do is we need to change that, and we can do that with drugs. We can also give electricity, which will stun the heart and reset the pacemaker so it goes back into a normal rhythm. The choice between drugs and electricity, we'll try the drugs first.
Yes.
And slow this heart rate down. OK, so there's adenosine, 6 milligrams.
Not wanting to lose any time, clinical practitioner Richard is ready to start the procedure.
Just keep nice and relaxed for me. Like you say, you know how horrible this feels.
Okay, very nice and steady for me.
It's quite frightening for patients. People often describe it as the sensation that you're going to die. It's because your heart's been stopped for just a short period of time.
Okay, Kerry, nice and steady.
Horrible, innit?
Tough as all bones.
Thank you.
OK, my friend, so that worked for a brief period of time and got you back into a normal rhythm, but then it's flipped again.
The drugs haven't worked, so another solution must be found fast. Back in the hub, in charge of today's shift is Sister Vicky.
I'm just waiting on Porter to take these up.
Got three?
Yeah.
And she's up against a very congested department.
No room, no capacity, no movement. We've got no movement up on wards. We've had a backlog of patients, so we've not been able to move anybody. His waiting room's absolutely full. All his cubicles are full.
Sister Vicky needs to get patients up onto the wards as quickly as possible.
What's your name, love?
Back in Rhesus, one of the patients has taken the team by surprise. Nurse Lisa should be clocking on for a shift tonight. Instead, she's being treated for a broken wrist.
So I've walked up and I'm like this muddy patch. I've like tried to avoid it and I've gone and slipped and landed on my bum and I must have put me in like that.
Oh, bless you.
Nurse Lisa needs her broken wrist bone pulled back into the right place. Dr. Helen Mercer is in charge of her colleague's care.
You need to pop a little cannula in the back of your hand, inject some local anaesthetic into your hand, so essentially it goes up to the tourniquet and everything where the anaesthetic is will go completely numb. So you're awake, but some people find it a bit weird because they're awake, but it is completely numb. Awake. You'd rather be awake. Do you want me to come round there, or do you think you might manage to put it down? Oh, well done.
That's
fine.
I'm so brave.
Sister Jane is also on hand.
Are you happy with that? Yeah, that's fine for me.
Sorry, Lisa.
I'll buy another.
To help alongside emergency nurse practitioner Kirsty.
Seeing Lisa with a wrist deformed and out of place is quite sad, really, because I know like how important her job is to her, and she's a great nurse. She likes to lift a pint, that's her pint hand holding hand as well, so I know she'll be disappointed about that.
Well done, sweetie.
So this one will stick down for now, but we need to take it out before we actually do any manipulating.
Dr. Mercer puts the cuff, known as the tourniquet, onto Nurse Lisa's arm to stop the blood flow into her wrist.
We need to make sure that it doesn't come undone, because if it did come undone and then the rest of the local anaesthetic goes into the rest of your body, then that could increase the risk of getting the toxicity.
With Dr. Mercer happy the cuff is secure, it's time to inflate it.
This top cuff's going to go up now, OK? If possible, can I try and lift your arm up a little bit? If it's uncomfortable, tell me. Is that OK? That's it. Perfect. It's just to help the blood drain out a bit.
With the cuff inflated, Dr. Mercer starts to inject Nurse Lisa with the local anaesthetic to numb her wrist.
Might feel cold, hot. If you start feeling funny in any way, just tell us. That's absolutely fine. Hands already getting a bit mottled. It's doing its job.
Next, the bone needs to be put back in the right place. If the procedure doesn't work, Nurse Lisa could be facing surgery.
And then we wait a couple more minutes, make sure it goes nice and numb.
We're treating like 100 patients in department, but obviously with influx that's coming in, I think we're going to be struggling.
Sister Vic is in charge of trying to get patient numbers down.
We are currently now at a 3-hour, 32-minute wait for a doctor.
But for now, she needs to make sure everyone's as comfortable as possible.
When you've done that, will you do me a safety round and a tea and biscuit round, please, Taff?
In Rhesus, clinical practitioner Richard is treating 61-year-old Kerry.
So Kerry's heart's in a funny rhythm at the moment, it's in what we call an SVT. And we just need to interrupt that signal to restore the normal pacemaker back.
He's already given him drugs intravenously, but so far, they've failed to work.
And so we're just going to give him a higher dose now.
If this higher dosage doesn't work, Kerry could be in great danger.
OK, you up for another go?
Yeah.
Well done.
But clinical practitioner Richard still can't get his heart back on track.
So we're doing so well. You've gone again. Let's have a rest. And we'll have a rethink about what we're going to do, OK?
OK.
I'm going to speak to the cardiology team about you.
OK.
And we'll get you sorted out, my friend, OK?
Thank you.
With Kerry in a serious condition, clinical practitioner Richard needs some specialist help.
This time it's really painful.
When
it goes? It's a very weird feeling. I've never experienced about like it in my life.
Nurse Ruth gives Kerry some morphine.
What's your pain out of 10 at the minute?
It's going to be a bit up, it's going to 9.
Until they can decide what to do next.
What I want to do is try and get that pain down without making your head go too fuzzy, OK?
But at risk of further heart complications, Kerry needs a solution fast. Another emergency has arrived at Barnsley. After an accident at a restaurant, a patient has been rushed in with severe burns.
I've had coffee spilt on my feet. I went out for breakfast and one of the staff has just spilt the coffee by accident when she was changing it.
28-year-old Katie had been out with her mum when the accident happened.
And I just took my socks and shoes off really quick, and then I've had my feet in water, cold water since, just to, which felt all right until I took it out of water, and then now it's burning.
Consultant Dr. Chris Young assesses the extent of her burns.
What happened? Coffee?
Yeah.
And it's fresh, was it?
Yeah.
What were you wearing on your feet?
Sliders and some socks.
So if you imagine when it's very red, it's a bit like a sub bath sunburn, if you like. It's the blistering bits that it's burned a bit deeper, okay?
Yeah.
Those are the bits that, and you've obviously got some here.
A burn, when it comes in, usually is very, very painful. If the burn isn't painful, strangely enough, actually, that's more concerning to me than one that is very painful. That would suggest that the burn has gone deep enough to actually damage the lower tissues in the skin, including the nerve endings. Those are the ones that potentially will need plastic surgery.
Severely damaged skin is at greater risk of infection, so the team needs to clean and treat Katie's injuries quickly.
Right, Katie, do you reckon we'll be all right to get her in your chair?
With no time to spare, she's taken down to Miners. In Miners, the next patient is certainly a first for Barnsley Casualty.
I can't move my feet at all. Quite weird, I've never experienced all that issues, especially with to do with a pig. Quite nerve-wracking.
26-year-old Scott was working in an abattoir when a pig's head fell from its hook onto his foot.
It's just throbbing like mad. I've took painkillers and it's just not touched sides.
The pig's tooth sliced into his foot.
Scott, can you come through?
Nurse Kirsty calls him in.
So how far has it fallen?
It's probably fell from that, but it's...
The head of the pig's just gone straight down into your foot.
Yeah,
of course,
obviously
yeah.
Gone through. Okay. I thought it was broken at first. Now all my leg up here, it's feel like tight and warm, as if that's swelling. Because all my foot here, it's, the pain is unreal.
Can I have a little feel of
it? Yeah,
That's so great.
I don't mind breaks and injuries, but don't like feet. It's just my one thing that I'm just not very good with. We all have our little quirks, and for me, that's it. I just don't like infected feet.
About further this way.
Yeah.
I think we probably should send you for an X-ray just to be certain that there's no fracture in there, and we'll give it a good clean, dress it, and we'll give you some antibiotics.
There's a good chance Scott's foot could be infected. It needs to be cleaned and bandaged as quickly as possible.
Hi, it's Hannah.
It's Matron Hannah's first day in her new role.
Have you got staff in for today? Because we're short tonight, aren't we?
Yeah, we're short all day.
Hello, Amy.
And it's not taken long for her first problem to arise.
When you sort of hear that ED is short on nursing staff, your first thing to wonder is, how are we going to fix it?
Oh. Katie and Amy are here, so Zane and Sharish rang in sick.
Okay. It really does disrupt how each member of staff works in every area. It has a negative effect on everyone. Everyone has to do a little bit more to cover them shortfalls.
One of the nurses who was due on shift tonight is instead receiving treatment in Rhesus for a broken wrist. Nurse Lisa's colleagues are trying to put the bones back together.
How's it feeling now?
Numb.
Yeah. Good.
She's wearing an inflated cuff, which cuts off the blood flow and isolates the local anaesthetic to her wrist.
I'm just going to press here. Is that sore at all? Not sore.
Good.
With the blood flow stemmed, the team has to act quickly to realign the bone.
I'll pass out.
All right. Yeah, as well.
Just do it.
Yeah. Nurse Kirsty is ready to start the procedure.
It's definitely hard to treat a colleague or a friend because you just want to get it right. You just want it to be the best it can be for them, and you do feel that added pressure because you know somebody and you're attached to them in a different way to a normal patient is.
It's now down to Nurse Kirsty to treat her friend's wrist.
You all right?
Morning, my cherub. You all right?
Volunteer Jane is on a mission.
Can I put a trolley in cubicle 7? You've not done that.
She's trying to help free up some space in the department.
Look at that, eh? Could have gone that Panama Canal, me, wouldn't I?
But she also has a problem of her own.
I'd got a wobbly trolley. It wobbled. You know, as you push it, it wobbled. So this kind young man, when I show him my wobbly bits, he's mending them. Because he's good at mending wobbly bits, aren't you, dearest?
I am.
I wish you could mend my wobbly bits as easy as you can mend them wobbly bits.
Just need to tighten up.
Don't we all sometimes, love? Don't we all?
It's great.
Is that bit? Oh, yeah. It don't wobble at all now, does it? What a man can do with a little bit of leadership.
In miners, next in line is 41-year-old Russell.
I'm a plater welder and I've been grinding. Put my glasses where I've been wearing, I've had a visor on. Unfortunately, sometimes it bounces off and goes in your eyes when you're grinding. There's not much I can do about it, really.
A piece of steel has got stuck in Russell's eye.
It's come through, Russell.
And the longer it's in there, the more damage it could cause. Emergency nurse practitioner Claire is free to see him.
Tell me a bit about what's happened today.
I've been doing some grinding and some piece of steel's bounced off me, overalls and into my eye.
And it's your left eye?
It is.
Yeah. Okay. I'm just going to put some drops in your eye just to numb it a little bit and then we'll do a quick eye test. Right, if you will just stand up against that back wall for me. Cover whichever eye up first. Can you read down the chart for me?
That's EHNDFNPTXZ. And then D, I'm struggling with that one, if I'm honest with you.
OK, first job, I'm just going to flip your eyelid up and just make sure there's nothing stuck underneath your lid, all right? Might feel a bit strange. OK, if you just look at me. Yeah, I can see it just right on the edge of your iris, isn't it?
Yeah.
About 8 o'clock. OK, so, right, let's have a little look through the slip lamp then. I'm just going to open your eye up a little bit. Up, back to me, and down.
Nurse Claire examines his eye to see if there's any damage.
Oh, it's quite a big piece. Almost looks like a piece of, like a black paint on it. Right, I'm going to have a quick look, see if I can try and just flick it out, all right? Have you had this done before?
Yeah, it feels nice. Occupational hazard.
If it can't be removed, it might lead to an infection or permanent scarring.
Just look forward for me, concentrate on one spot.
It's a needle. I'm not going into the eye. I'm just going to try and scrape and flick it out, all right? If you want me to stop at any point, just let me know, all right?
Nice and still for me. Concentrate on one spot for me.
Such an intricate procedure is challenging for Nurse Claire.
That's it.
That's the one.
Yeah.
Quite big, isn't
it? Isn't it? Obviously, it's going to be a little bit sore, some general paracetamol if you need it, but it looks like it's all out. I can't see a rush ring underneath, so I think I've got it all out.
Lovely.
All right?
Yeah, that's fine. Thank you very much.
You're welcome.
Can I take that with me just to...
Yeah, of course you can. Do you want to clean one?
Thank you.
All right.
Cheers.
OK, take care.
Bye.
Bye.
When people get foreign bodies, it's probably easier if they come on the same day for removal. They are a bit better to get out on that day. When they leave it, it tends to grow a film type of thing over the eye, and it's much more harder to get the foreign body out.
Luckily for Russell, he heads home with his vision intact. In the hub, Sister Vicky is still juggling an overflowing department.
What rooms did we have free?
I've just gone into 8.
Is this one free now, love? Robert, can I have number 1 into 7, love, please?
When numbers in the department do get very high, it is very, very stressful because you're trying to figure out how you can move these patients, who needs to be seen first, priority times, target times. It's having to move the patients and having to juggle the department to make it safe all the time.
Come on, Libby. Watch your bum.
Over in Resus.
Just do it.
Nurse Lisa is in the middle of having her broken wrist pulled back into place by Nurse Kirsty.
Are you all right?
Yeah.
Okay. It's probably me that's hit.
It felt like June.
Yeah. Pop. Yeah.
Having repositioned the bone.
Yeah.
It's time for Sister Jane to plaster Nurse Lisa's arm.
I don't like putting a pot on me, you know, without that little tubey grip thing.
No, sorry.
I don't. This is how they do it in EMP world, love. It's just... just doesn't feel professional.
And start slagging us off now. Thank you so much, everyone.
Oh, Lise.
Good work.
Nurse Lisa might feel better, but she's still got to have an X-ray on her wrist. If it's not properly aligned, she will need surgery in the next 24 hours.
Feel better?
Oh, much better, thank you.
Look after yourself, won't you?
I will.
We're on 96 patients in department.
Sister Vicky is halfway through her shift and still struggling with a packed department.
I know a majority of them are GP and paediatrics.
Yeah, it's not slowing down, is it?
It's really a long wait.
In Minors, 27-year-old Katie is waiting for treatment on her scalded feet. Tasked with the procedure, is emergency nurse practitioner Becky.
A minute, what are you even doing?
I went out for breakfast and someone spilt the fresh coffee pot on my feet.
So the thing with burns is while ever it's exposed to the open air, that is why it's sore. So that is why we say get it wrapped up as soon as we can. So we'll get you on this couch, have a quick look at it. If there's any blisters, I'll be taking those off because that skin is now dead. That blister skin is now dead, and that fluid that's sitting on the fresh skin is just stopping the new skin from healing, if that makes sense. So what were you doing? Were you going out for breakfast with friends? Or?
Just with my mum, yeah.
About right, isn't it? These things are sent to try us. Right, let me put you over to Rosie's bed. I'm going to put you on bed just because it's easier to have a look at you. I love burns. Love burns. Love de-roofing and love, because it's a wound and I just love getting stuck in with wounds. Yeah, I like burns. The thing with burns is that the more painful they are, the more superficial they are, if that makes sense. So the deep burns, you've got no pain because you've burnt through all your nerves and stuff. So the ones that are just superficial, that all your nerves are like that, so they're not happy, you know, so that's why they're really, really sore. Okay, we'll start with this one first. To our clinic. You okay?
Yeah.
Well done. Sorry, sweetheart, I know how sore they are.
It's quite a weird sensation, actually.
Sorry. Not good for morphine, eh? So the fluid that you get is normal?
Yeah.
With burns? All right. Yeah. It's your body's natural defence. But it's important that you put that fluid back in. All right, so drink plenty of water.
Yeah.
In a couple of days. We'll just chat away and just to distract them, really. And then, you know, every few minutes I'll just say, you okay? And can you bear it? Yeah, I'm fine. And if they want a break, we'll give them a break. But I just think sometimes just the quicker the better, just get it on with it and get them covered, and then pain is then significantly reduced.
Nearly done, sweetheart. Nearly done. You're so well.
You all right there?
Yeah.
It's going to go down to your toes, I'm afraid, this.
It's all right.
When you get home and you've got it rested and you're a bit more relaxed, it'll start to feel a lot better.
Yeah.
Any problems at all, don't hesitate to come back before Friday. OK. So wiggle the toes for me. Lovely. So you can still keep them moving and you can feel me touching, yeah?
Yeah.
All right, my lovely. Yeah. You'll take care.
Thank you.
Bye, lovey. Most of them superficial, but she has got a few areas that are a little bit worse than others, that will take a little bit longer to heal. But I'm sure that they'll be healed and sorted in a couple of weeks at the most. All being well.
Katie's lucky her skin will have no permanent damage.
Thank you, Ta.
She was discharged from the burns clinic a few days later. Nurse Lisa is on her way to radiology for an X-ray on her broken wrist.
Just on that wheelchair, please. Thank you.
If the bones are still not in the right place, she'll need surgery. Devastatingly, this would mean months off work.
We're all finished.
Nurses Claire and Kirsty assess the results.
Now I think it looks a lot better.
Yeah.
I mean, it's not brilliant, but compared to your other one,
you're still going to need fixing.
Yeah, but we might as well refer to virtual fracture clinic. There's not much they're going to do today, is there?
A bit upset now. I need surgery.
It's better that though now.
Yeah.
Than having a long-term problem with an
arthritis. Oh, yeah.
It's a moment in time, isn't it now?
Never mind.
Lisa not being on shift tonight will definitely increase the pressure tonight. She's one of the most experienced staff nurses that we've got. She's a real vital member of the team. She's great, really, so to lose her for a few weeks will definitely add pressure to the department.
The next day, Nurse Lisa had surgery. And after 3 months' recuperation, she's now back at work. In Rhesus, after a few failed attempts to get patient Kerry's heart rate back to normal, clinical practitioner Richard calls the cardiology department for help.
I've given him 3 lots of adenosine. I was just thinking whether it's safe to knock in some verapamil on top of that, or whether I should just stick with the beta blockers.
Now, is that fuzziness in your head? Are you feeling okay?
Yeah.
Yeah, would you like a little bit more morphine?
Please.
Patients often present to the emergency department with different conditions related to different specialities. So we get that best 15 minutes of every speciality where we can deliver life-saving treatments. But after that, we'll often have to refer on. And certainly in Kerry's case, things haven't gone to plan, so I want expert advice. We're going to book your bed on the coronary care unit.
OK.
You're going to go up there and they'll get this heart rate under control for you.
Thank you.
Yeah, so we'll keep an eye on you, OK?
You're being brilliant.
That's what it's all about, isn't it? OK, bud?
Well, we've got to show you appreciation, haven't we?
Oh, definitely.
But Kerry's treatment is far from over.
Well, I'm feeling a bit scared, actually, because it's one of your main organs in your body, isn't it, your heart? I mean, once that backs up, you completely... You keep that, haven't you?
He needs specialist care.
Most expensive port to push you back.
So he's taken up to the cardiology unit.
A-star treatment, this one.
There, they manage to bring his heart rate down, but his condition is still being investigated.
Spin to win.
Green.
This is International Nurses Day, and we're just bringing round the wheel of fun and fortune to all of our nursing staff to celebrate.
Oh, the spins do we get?
Much better.
Oh, Jed, you like your
blue.
Thank you.
You're
welcome. Happy
Nurses Day. It's nice to get recognised for the hard work that people have done, especially over the pandemic, where people have gone that extra mile to help out and to work hard.
Anybody else?
Nursing staff do a fantastic job in the NHS day in, day out, and it's good to recognise the work that we do.
Thank
you. One person hoping he's not got a long wait is 4-year-old Carter. He's in paediatrics with Mum Sarah.
Yeah. You've got to wait, haven't you? See about your head.
Dr. Joe Bennett sees how he can help.
Are you okay there? Something's happened. You hear your head? How did you hear your head? This. Can I have a little look while you tell me?
What are you doing?
Oh, blimey. What did you do?
What did you have in your hand?
A flying saucer.
A flying saucer.
And it's attacked you, has it?
Fell onto the corner of a brick.
Fine, so it's not the flying saucer.
No, it's not that. That's not attacked.
He's evaded the flying saucer very nimbly, but unfortunately not evaded the brick.
No.
Fine, okie dokie. I think that will glue nicely. I'm just going to be annoying and shine the light in your eye. So you step my nose. Oh my gosh. Perfect. Can I have a little look in your look holes? Is that alright? You stay over there at that wall. Can you follow my finger? Can I shake your hand? It's a pleasure to meet you. Can I get you up and watch you walk around? Perfect! Look at that strong. Fine. So, from a bash on the head point of view, I'm relatively happy with it. I think you'll need a little bit of glue there. Once the glue's on, you'll need to try and keep it dry for about 3 to 5 days.
Unfortunately for Carter, he's got a little bit longer to wait before going home.
Do you have any questions for me?
No.
Smash it.
Great.
Matron Hannah is 6 hours into the first shift of her new role.
I'm following your arm, Rach.
She's managed to come up with a solution for the night shift's nursing shortage.
Tonight, Stacey's coming in later for her shift so that she can stay longer to support him tonight.
Right, okay.
So she'll probably not be here at normal 2 o'clock. It might be 4, 5-ish when she gets here. ED is one of them environments that never sort of changes. It don't matter what role you're at, you always want to be involved in that. And I think as a matron, for me being here in the chaos and the carnage that does come with ED, it's good for the team, it's good for us all to stick together.
You look rounder than when you went to Mexico. Unless it's a colour.
Maybe it's the black.
Suits you.
Thank you.
Yeah, well,
I've just told Rachel Stacey's coming in later because it gaps on nights.
So I said Steph had offered to do a twilight with me today, but she says I can't because it would look it's your left in the morning.
Yeah,
I'll take it this afternoon, no problem.
Right, I will see you in a bit.
Meanwhile, in Miners, 26-year-old Scott, who works in an abattoir, is back from an X-ray after a pig's head fell on his foot.
Are we all right?
Yeah.
Can you manage? Do you want me to push you in?
Nurse Kirsty, who's overseeing his treatment, has some news.
A cracking slip as them.
All right, aren't they?
Come back through. Looks like you have a tooth in your wound. So it looks like it's broken off from the pig.
So there's a pig's tooth in my foot?
Yeah, it's a story to tell, isn't it?
Yeah. Nah, it's the first I've ever heard of that. That has, but I'm shocked. Very shocked by that.
Scott has been treated for an animal bite, but things are now more complicated.
I can remember saying to lads, I was like, oh, look, you can see it bone, and they were like, bone. And now I'm thinking, well, maybe it walked tooth that I saw at first. And now...
Quite possibly. They're going to need to get that out.
Yes.
And they're going to need to wash that area out as well. So it will be a case of going to theatre for that doing. It's in the soft tissue, it's the bone. Animal bites are quite dirty. They've got a lot of bacteria in the mouths. We always give antibiotics for bites. It's one of the only things that we give antibiotics for prophylactically, just because they are prone to becoming infected. Pig bites is definitely a new one on me. So, if you wouldn't mind just taking a seat for us, and as soon as orthopaedic doctors come down, they will grab your notes off me and we will see what they want to do with you from there.
To prevent a serious infection...
Thank you.
You're all right.
Scott will need surgery to remove the tooth.
But yeah, something I've definitely never seen in my career or anywhere, a pig's tooth in a foot.
It's shock now more than anything. It's a shock that's got me. Like I say, expected at least a new broken toe from it, not the tooth actually inside my foot.
It's only, 6 hours ago since he did it, and it's already bright red, really shiny. You can see there's an infection brewing there already.
If there's any infection start spreading, I would just want to get it out. If I'd have known there was something, I'd have gone myself. You're just not going to expect a pig's tooth to be in your foot, are you? You couldn't write it, could you?
An infection could lead to further complications for Scott, so time is of the essence. In Barnsley A&E.
How many you got on that corridor?
Another one.
Is there nothing on blue?
Sister Vicky is still struggling.
We're just absolutely swamped. We've just got no movement, we've got no capacity, we've got nowhere to go at the moment.
There are 87 patients in the department and a four-hour wait.
So it's just making sure that everything's safe, the patients are safe, the staff are safe, all observations are up to date, and our patients have been fed and watered as well, so hopefully, fingers crossed, when I hand over in next half an hour or so, that... I can hand over a decent department. It's just going to have a knock-on effect for night staff. And then, again, when I come back again tomorrow, it could probably have a knock-on effect for me for day shift again tomorrow.
Scott is waiting to see a doctor.
Hello?
Hello?
I've got a pig's tooth in my foot.
So he's taking the time to update his girlfriend.
How's that after that? Would you not know?
I thought it was my bone. Obviously, it weren't my bone, it was a pig's tooth. I've got to go down into theatre, they've got to remove it.
What do you mean?
Because the pig's tooth's gone in and snapped off in my foot, so there's a bit of pig's tooth. I'll give you a ring when I've been down into theatre.
No, you ring me and let me know when you're going in.
All right, love. Love you, mate. I don't think she's too impressed, is she?
Scott's called in to see the doctor to discuss next steps. Back in the hub, volunteer Jane has a delivery.
Oh, thank you very much. Can you put this through X-ray machine?
Jane wastes no time in finding out what's in the parcel.
It's done back and off. Somebody sent this. It's for us all, obviously. It's for a sweet draw. Oh, Turkish delight. So I'm sorry there's none of you getting these now, because I'm keeping them. Sorry, but I'm taking them home with me.
Scott has been to see the doctor about his upcoming surgery. Unfortunately, it's not good news.
The tooth gone under that bone and it's lodged between them two toes there. So they've got to cut it from up here, round like that, and down there to pull it back so they can wash it all to try and stop any infection growing up into my leg. I hope it just doesn't go any further. I just hope. Touch wood. Hello? So yeah, I've got a staying. They're gonna do it today at theatre, so it's not gonna be yet because they're busy and they need a doctor to do it just yet, or a nurse, whatever. All right, love. Goodbye.
It's now down to the surgical team to remove the tooth from his foot and prevent any serious infection.
Right, Scott, we'll take you down to surgical aesthetic, all right? Yeah, we'll get you ready for theatre and then we'll go from there.
Yeah,
okay?
Yeah, that's yeah. Fine.
All right, then off we go. Good luck.
Thank you.
If Scott decided to leave his injury untreated, he could develop an infection in there, which then could lead him to become septic. Or the infection could spread into the bones, which could have the potential to have life-changing injuries and affect him for the rest of his life.
Scott's surgery was delayed until the following day, when he had the 2-centimetre pig's tooth taken out of his foot. Unfortunately, the accident has left him with ongoing nerve damage. In paediatrics...
Can we just take a picture?
4-year-old Carter and mum Sarah have been waiting to have his cut glued after a fall.
Right then, yeah. Dude.
Got my magic glue. Fix you all up back in one piece and then you can go home.
Sister Naomi is on hand to help.
Lie down
flat on the bed then.
Lie down on your back.
Looking at the ceiling on your back, look.
Good job.
Hey, I bet this is the best wash you've had in a while, isn't it? Is it? You like my lot and allergic to water.
Oh, he likes a bath because he gets a bath bomb, yeah.
Do you like bath bombs?
Yeah.
Right, let's give it a dry. Make sure it's all nice and dry. And then I've got my magic glue then. Is that all right?
You ready?
In here somewhere.
To make sure it's all dry, though. We don't want you sticking to anything, do we?
Just sit up now. We're all done.
Oh, good boy.
Perfect.
Well done.
Star patient of the day.
Yay!
Shall I find you a sticker?
Good boy. You're very brave, aren't you?
Which do you think you might like to choose? You don't know. What about one that says I bump my head? The yellow one. Where do you want it? On there? You having it on your head? Like that? No. On your T-shirt. There you go.
Oh, good job.
Perfect. I think for today, so far, you'll get star patient of the day, definitely. Come on, then.
Come on, then.
All fixed up, star patient Carter and his mum, Sarah, head home.
Robert. I need your assistance to go with the cubicle 4. I can go in a wheelchair, yeah. Up to ward with my lovely colleague here.
Slowly but surely, Sister Vicky's finally moving patients out of the department.
A is ready, so I'll get somebody to take A up.
Yep.
And then I'll find space for the other one.
Oh, lovely.
As for Matron Hannah, her first day as matron is over.
See you in a bit.
Working in ED, we work with a very special group of people. I think ED nurses are a bit of a different breed. We're all a bit loud, we're all a bit proud, but what's the best thing about them all is they'll pull together. It's a family. And I think that's something that every one of us that work here is really, really proud of. It's something that I'm proud of, and it's a wonderful place to work.
And while Matron Hannah heads home, the casualty department remains open 24/7. Next time on Casualty 24/7.
Still got pain, Stephen?
Oh.
You all right?
It does.
Can you see my face normally?
Yeah. But it's a bit blurred, yes.
Is it?
Don't shut that. It's nearly 32 degrees in here. Oh.
like Marilyn Monroe, aren't I?
And new Casualty 24/7 is back at the usual time next Monday at 9. It was first believed to be a robbery gone wrong, but there was much more to the case of Rachel O'Reilly, the lie, murder in suburbia, Thursday at 10. Next, grave concerns for one RTA patient in 909 critical condition.